Good morning and welcome. Today we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please take this moment right now to greet those around you. Our celebrant this morning is Father Greg Doncoye, and our entrance hymn is found in the Breaking Bread, number 747. This is my song, number 747. And our choir now is on vacation for the rest of the summer. Please rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and the peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. It is the day of the Lord again, the day of the resurrection. We come together to praise the Lord for his love. St. Paul tells the Corinthians, and he tells us, Christ became poor that we might become rich. It's not just material riches, but he shares all his spiritual riches with us by allowing us to be called God's children. We come to celebrate our adoption, and we celebrate the day of the resurrection that Christ has won for us. And so let us enter into this intimacy with God our Father by recognizing where we stand before him, that we are sinners in need of his compassion and healing. Lord Jesus Christ, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Lord Jesus Christ, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christe, Christe, eleison.
Christe, Christe,
Jesus Christ, your word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Kyrie, Kyrie,
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living, for he fashioned all things that they might have being, and for the creatures of the world are wholesome, and there is not a destructive drug among them, nor any domain nor of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable, but by the image of his own nature he made them. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me, and have not let my enemies rejoice over me. Soul from the dead, restored me to life from those who sink into the grave.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Sing psalms to the Lord, you who love him. Give thanks to his holy name. His anger a moment, his favor all through life. At night there are tears, but joy comes with dawn.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
The Lord listened and had pity. The Lord came to my help. For me you have changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord my God, I will thank you forever.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as you excel in every respect, in faith, discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but that as a matter of equality, your abundance at the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
We are taking the shorter form of the gospel. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him, and he stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials named Jairus came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come lay your hands on her that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid. Just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talita kum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we face many challenges in our experience as human beings. The greatest challenge we face is death. And all cultures throughout the ages have confronted the mystery of dying in different ways. Many in the Roman Empire confronted with bravery. In Julius Caesar, we hear cowards die many times before their death. The valiant never tastes of death but once. That's their way of approaching death. In my own culture, we confront death through myths and fables, blaming the dog for destruction. Otherwise, men should die and come back, while the moon should have died permanently. But now the moon dies and comes back, and we die permanently. Unraveling the mystery of death will not lessen the pain of loss and separation brought on by death. However, some people still believe that when they blame God, the psychological pain reduces. So it's God's fault. Others deny the existence of God altogether as their way of coping with the mystery of death. God does not exist, so if you die, that's all of it. Some scientists are on a hunt to eliminate death as a human reality. A couple of years ago, I read that the scientists are getting this close, that in 50 years, death will be eliminated. I don't know if you have read that too. While others opt for euthanasia or suicide to avoid the absurdity of suffering and death. Today, the author of the Book of Wisdom, written about 100 years before the coming of Christ, proposed another approach to confront the reality of suffering and oppression in his day. He says that despite the challenges we face, sickness, failure, suffering, war, and death, despite these realities, life in general should be seen as a precious gift of God. He says, if God hated us, he would not create us in the first place. What God has created is beautiful. We should accept it as a gift. He argues that suicide and euthanasia are not endorsed by God. He doesn't like that. Life is what God chooses. He believes that God did not make us to suffer and to die for nothing. There is a hidden purpose in the suffering of the innocent. That is his purpose. And in the gospel, we can witness the response of God's love in the plight of the suffering and death of Jesus. Jesus does not respond to the mystery of suffering and death by theoretical or philosophical discussions. He enters into the reality of suffering and death. We have the answer in the book to the Hebrews, in the letter to the Hebrews, where the author says, Christ was like us in everything but sin. That during his life on earth, Jesus prayed, weeping in loud lamentation, calling upon the one who could save him from death. And that he prayed was so humble that his prayer was accepted. This was Christ's response to death. He confronted death to give us hope. He participates in our sufferings and gives us the hope that there is the resurrection. So, in raising Jairus' little daughter from death, he invites us to focus on the fuller life, eternal life,
that we shall attain with him if we confront our earthly trials with faith in his love for us. On the cross, we see God's answer to the mystery of suffering and death. So many times, I go to visit the sick, and there is no word. I share their fear. I also fear to die. But what is the answer? Christ on the cross says, "Do not be afraid. I've taken the lead." And there is resurrection. You only have to believe and trust in me. The daughter of Jairus will die again. Lazarus, raised from the dead, will die again. It would have been better if Christ did not raise Jairus' daughter, because she will die again. He did that to give us the belief that he will do more. That is the miracle. It's a foretaste of what will happen to all of us. And so we live as people of hope. Every Sunday we celebrate this reminder, faith of our resurrection when our mortality overtakes us. And Christ says, "I am the resurrection. I am the life. He who believes in me, even if you die, you shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day." And very soon, we will profess that we believe in the resurrection and the life everlasting.
Please stand and let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again from the dead in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead in the life of the world to come. Trusting in the Lord's graciousness, let us offer our prayers for the church and for our world.
For the church, may the Holy Spirit continue to animate her missionary work throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For areas of the world brutalized by war and violence, especially Niger, Sudan, Azerbaijan, Ukraine, and the Holy Land, May the Lord bring his peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick or suffering, may God mercifully grant them healing and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of Al Restivo, Teresa Sung, Lenny Shin, Patricia Scott, and Gus Gomez, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families in this faith community, may they be always open to the workings of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died with faith in the Lord, especially Beverly Holt, Alice Benoit, Henry Suarez, Kathleen Bice, and Pat, may God grant them the reward he has promised his faithful servants. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of Susan Stevenson, Patricia, Miles and Oscar Yum, Jill McGill, and Helena Son, and the souls of Bruce Fost, Anthony Artukovich, Dominic Sardo, Katerina Lee, and Ted Walters, who are remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear our prayers and answer them in accordance with your holy will. Grant this through Christ our Lord. My dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries among us, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts we offer, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with yours in one chorus of exultant praise as we proclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember the intentions of Susan, Patricia, Miles, Oscar, Jill, Helena, and the souls of Bruce, Anthony, Dominic, Katerina, and Ted, whom you have called from this life, and all our friends, brothers, and loved ones who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Blessed Bede, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold our resurrection and our life. He has taken away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy to receive you, but don't say the word.
Join us in singing number 581. Worthy is the Lamb, number 581 in the Breaking Bread.
Slain to receive
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for a few announcements. First of all, if you could take out the Eucharistic Revival prayer cards found on the front of the breaking breads and loosely in the pews, we'll pray that prayer together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who promised to stay with us always until the end of the age. Reawaken our wonder at his presence in the most holy Eucharist. May our hearts burn within us as he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Give us the eyes of faith to recognize his presence in our brothers and sisters, especially in the face of the poor and the suffering. Nourished by the Eucharist, send us forth to walk faithfully as missionary disciples, proclaiming the gospel to every heart and extending your kingdom to every land. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a few announcements. Vacation Bible Camp registration is available on our parish website. The camp starts July 8th. That's for 1 week for 5 through 12 year olds. Also, once a month we have 24-hour adoration, Eucharistic adoration. Hours for July starts tomorrow right after the 8:10 Mass. Continues around the clock until Tuesday morning before the 8:10 Mass. If you can commit to an hour, please do so. Commitments are made on the parish website. If you cannot commit, that's fine. Just please show up if you can and pray for everyone here at St. Bede, especially those in need. And I can always use a few prayers too, so thank you on that one. The parish center and campus is closed this Thursday and Friday for the holiday. The Knights of Columbus are selling tickets for bingo July 13th outside the Coffee and Donuts, which are being hosted by RCIA. Thanks to our cantors and Emil, our master organist. Thank you to our Father Greg from Ghana, who is here with us through the middle of August, helping us out. I appreciate his presence. His sanctity, his inspiration. Thank you to our altar servers, extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion, lectors, ushers, and sacristans. How about a big round of applause for all of them? Thank you for your support. Thank you for your presence. Let us just continue to lift one another up as we move forward on this journey towards our ultimate home in heaven. And on behalf of all the staff at St. Bede, we wish you all a happy and blessed and safe 4th of July holiday.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever.
Amen.
This celebration is ended. Go forth in the peace and the joy of Christ. Thanks be. Have a wonderful week.
And in celebration of the 4th of July, join us in singing number 745, America the Beautiful, verse 1 and 3.